At the halfway mark of the season, Sydney seemed destined to finish on the bottom rungs of the top eight. And if you were looking at their form line by round 10 when they were in 7th place with a 6-4 record, one finals win may have seemed possible, but it was hard to imagine progression after that. Indeed, the Swans had struggled to put consecutive victories together, and the only time they had stuck three straight wins on the board was against strugglers North Melbourne, West Coast and Hawthorn, and that included a lucky escape against North. Suddenly, they are on a 9-game winning streak and in an AFL Grand Final. So how did this happen? Watch the video above, Lance Franklin's full press conference. Analysis, local footy and the biggest moments, 7 and 7 Plus are the home of footy shows for every fan. Stream them all for free on 7 Plus. You've got that Dylan feeling. Dylan Stevens has been in and out of the Sydney team since the Swans used pick 5 to grab him in the 2019 National Draft. This year the 21-year-old left footer played the first 3 games of the season but was dropped after the Swans lost to the Bulldogs. Stevens didn't return to the side until round 15 against St Kilda, and he was back with a bang, too, setting a PB with a 23 disposal game. Since then, he has played every game, breaking that PB with 25 disposals against Adelaide in round 19 and locking down that spot on the wing. Enter the Clarksman. And the frontal pressure the Swans forward mix has changed throughout the year, and there was uncertainty who should be the other small/medium forward to join Isaac Heaney, Will Hayward, and Tom Buckley. After trying several combinations, they've landed on Ryan Clark, who has rapidly moved up the pecking order ahead of Sam Wicks, James Bell, and Ben Ronkay. The spot was seemingly Wicks to lose after he played 22 games in 2021. Poor form and ill discipline seemed to seal his fate, however, and Clark came into the side to nullify the opposition's running defenders, a job which he's done with aplomb. Dubbed the Clarksman, the former Roo has question marks over his use of the football by hand and foot, but his ability to stick to his task and sweat on opponent is first class. It's not just Clark, however, with the Swans having full buy-in on pressure from their forwards to be the no. One ranked team in the competition for inside 50 tackles. Rise of the fantastic Mr. Fox. Probably one of the biggest surprises for the Swans this season is the form of 29-year-old defender Robbie Fox. Fox has been delisted and re-rookied by the Swans and was not considered for the first half of the season, in which he injured his hamstring in the VFL. He was the medical sub in round 11, came in and out of the team, then was selected again in round 15 and has not missed a game since. Included in this streak was a sequence of 23, 24 and 25 possession games to cement his place in the team and become a valued contributor, so much so the Swans have offered him a new 2-year contract after having signed 1-year deals in his first 6 seasons. Ollie, Ollie Ollie, oi, oi, oi. Not much has been said about Ollie Floron's move to halfback this season. The Swans have held high hopes for Floron since he was drafted with pick 11 in 2016, and we've seen flashes of his immense talent over the years. But this season has been his most consistent to date, and it has come with a permanent shift to Floron's role. The speedster has been tried in the middle and on the wing in his formative years, but now the Swans have successfully transformed him into a dashing defender. But Floron can also play a lockdown role, and has had jobs on Brisbane's Zach Bailey, Fremantle's Michael Walters, and Richmond's Shai Bolton this year. You wouldn't read about it. Sam Reed's spot in the team was certainly not guaranteed at the start of the year. He didn't feature until round 4, with the Swans opting for young key position player Hayden McLean at the start of the season and also using forward rucks Peter Latham's and Joe Lamardi. But in round 11, Reed impressed in Sydney's thrilling win over the Tigers with 3 goals, and followed that up with a belter against Melbourne, bagging another 3 and picking up 16 disposals. From then on, Reed was locked into the team and his sticky hands and contested marking have been a feature. If he doesn't get up for the grand final, he will be sorely missed. Here's Tommy Part 1. Although Tom Buckley was named in this year's All-Australian squad, he missed the first 6 rounds of the season with a hamstring injury. Not only that, Buckley took a while to find the form that rocketed him into the All-Australian team last year. But, when he did get his touch back, the Swans also started to get going. The use of Buckley in the midfield is not new to this season, but we're seeing more of him at the centre stoppage, and it's also paying dividends. Here's Tommy Part 2. Journeyman Tom Hickey's first year in Sydney was nothing short of sensational. However, this year he injured his knee in round 3 and didn't return until round 9. In that game we saw the pairing of Hickey and Latham's, which was dubbed a spectacular fail the following week when the Swans lost to Carlton and the pair had 24 hitouts between them, compared to young blue Tom De Koning's 23. Hickey again pulled up sore with a toe injury and missed another 4 games. After Latham's meltdown against his old club Port Adelaide in round 14, Hickey returned for the St Kilda clash and started to show signs of his previous season's form with a 22-possession game. He still struggled for a few weeks after and at times looked very sore, but by round 21 he was back with an outstanding 38-hit-out effort against season ruckman Todd Goldstein. Of course, one of his best games was in the first final against Melbourne. Other things of note: Nick Blakey's move to halfback happened last year, but the electric lizard has made the spot his own this season and is now key to Sydney's ball movement out of the backline, taking over the role from Jake Lloyd. The Swans did their best to keep Josh Kennedy in the team this season, which included a failed move to halfback. Kennedy was the Medi sub against Hawthorn and was fantastic when he came on, but injury has forced the Swans' hand and it spared them a tricky call on the Warriors' illustrious career. Sydney's game plan of corridor at all costs came horribly unstuck when they took on Gold Coast at the SCG and they were humiliated by the visitors. It forced a small tweak to their style and now they have a slow play plan in their back pocket and are happy to hug the boundary line when required. And finally, thank you all for watching the video. Please like and comment your opinion so we can discuss together. Don't forget to subscribe, press the bell to follow and update many other interesting news. See you in the next videos. Goodbye.